Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In part 16 of the Effects Environment series, you'll learn about the new cache on playback functionality, as well as the render indications which are now available in the Effects Environment with Flame 2020. So you're now able to see the render state of each segment without having to switch to the timeline view, and you can also interactively cache your renders as you work within this environment. This video is not footage specific, so please use your own media to follow along. As a quick recap, cache on playback has been available in the timeline for quite some time. For example, in the timeline view, if you were to select a segment and apply a timeline effects using the effects ribbon, you would see the result, but it would remain unrendered even if you scrubbed or played the segment. So cache on playback is off by default, and you would have to press the render button to process the result. To enable cache on playback, you click the options pull-down menu and choose cache on playback. This setting is persistent, so once you turn it on, it should stay on until you turn it off. Now when you scrub or play the sequence, whichever frames are displayed in the viewer will automatically be cached to disk as part of the render. So that's the concept, and this allows you to work interactively with your renders in the timeline view. Now let's move on to another shot and switch to the effects environment. Firstly, I just want to point out that cache on playback in the timeline view and the effects environment are considered as two separate functions. This is because you may want caching in one part of Flame and not in another. So turning it on in the timeline view will not turn it on in the effects environment and vice versa. Secondly, like the timeline view, cache on playback is also not on by default. For example, I'll throw a quick grade on the shot. Scrubbing or playing the time bar, the render indications above the shot in the storyboard remain unrendered. To enable cache on playback within the effects environment, click the Playback Options pull-down menu and choose Cache on Playback. This setting is also persistent, so it will stay on until you turn it off. Now you'll note almost straight away that the current frame gets cached, and the render indications show a partial render with a dotted line. If you adjust the effect, the current frame will be recached and the partial render indication will remain. Only when all the frames have been scrubbed or played back, the render indication will change to a solid black line as a complete render. So the indications are a great visual tool to have. But for any reason you don't want to see them, you can click on the Playback Options pull-down menu and turn them off through the storyboard display. So you can move on to another shot, work on your look development, and then scrub or play to review and cache the result. When you return to the timeline view, you'll see that the segments are already shown as rendered and no further processing should be required. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2020. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.